All right, Smashers, what is up? Done working out. Another awesome Monday hanging out at CSA. We have the crew over there doing all kinds of fun stuff. We're going to be talking about shin splints today. Here's the deal. Shin splints not coming from what you think they're coming from. Let's go like this so I can do this. So the way a shin splint works is you're having an issue with the mechanics of the entire lower leg, for one, but that is secondary to the mechanics of the upper leg, so the hip, the quads, the entire complex, primarily the rectus femoris. And then we're going to go on the outside of the posterior compartment. Posterior compartment. Listen, I'm tired. I just did a workout. Awful. The biceps femoris. So the biceps femoris runs around along the outside. But imagine this. Here's what happens. It gets really short, really tight, and really glued down. And this is the mechanic portion, or the mechanical portion. So it's basically a neuromechanical deficiency, which contributes to causing that shin splint because your foot can't work right. The gastroc soleus plantaris, so the calf complex, can't work right. And then that tibialis anterior and posterior don't work right. So the foot starts to collapse, which means you start to use and load muscles incorrectly, and you start to chew up the attachments. So you get these little avulsion fractures all the way down along the anterior portion of the shin and behind that compartment where that tibialis posterior is. So there's a lot of stuff going on. I realize I just spat out a bunch of information that's probably minutiae to most people, but that's okay. Here's the deal. Fix the upper leg, fix the hip, you wind up fixing the lower leg, and I'm gonna show you how to strengthen the tibialis posterior and reclaim a lot of that arch. I realize most of it comes from the hip, but there's a little small piece of it that's coming from that tibialis posterior. I'm gonna show you how to strengthen that as well, and then clear out those shin splints so when you go running, you're not slapping around like a duck when you're running, you're actually cushioning and running the way you're supposed to with a little absorption on the arch and then a rebound spring, so you're not using so much muscle and you're using more of a tissue rebound instead of you're doing it the way you're supposed to versus how you're not supposed to do it. You're running like a robot, right? Super, super crappy. Listen, I'm tired. It's a Monday. I'm sorry. We're gonna crank this up super high. All right, so here's what we do. First things first, what we do is we take, let's grab our trusty J-hook. So we need to unload the biceps femoris, and here's why. The biceps femoris, imagine this, it's gonna act like a bowstring on the outside of the leg, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. And this is what causes a lot of problems with the mechanics of the lower leg and the knee. So if we look at the biceps femoris, runs around the outside here. So imagine it comes in here, it's gonna act like a bowstring on the outside, and it's gonna wind up collapsing in. But when it collapses in, it collapses the arch. As the arch collapses, it starts to load up the tibialis posterior and tibialis anterior and all the stuff in the posterior compartment, so that whole calf complex. So I'm gonna show you how to clean it up. So we're gonna hit the rectus femoris on the front and the tibialis posterior on the back, all in one move. Yeah, this is pretty trick. So we'll go like this. You can see I got the weight sitting there. So what we do is we want a box. Let's move this over. This is really heavy. I'm using a 35 pound bar because it's narrower, so it's gonna trap more tissue, or it's gonna trap a finer amount of tissue, smaller amount of tissue, so it's a little more aggressive. This ball is gonna go right along that biceps femoris, right along the outside. If the bar doesn't escape on you, you're gonna tuck that in real high, so right up in here, and then we're gonna start kicking in and out while this is sitting on top. So first thing we do is we pick this up, set it across the lap, right? Now we take this, tuck it underneath, make sure our weight doesn't fall off. See, I'm not using clips, dangerous, don't do that. Danger, Will Robinson, danger. So you can see, I have the lacrosse ball tucked in right underneath that biceps femoris, and I'm gonna use this, and I'm gonna find that, sandwich it right in between, just like that. And then I'm just gonna kick in and out, and I'm gonna work my way all the way down with the ball and with the bar, and then I'm gonna load it even further. Oh, that's miserable. Even Brad over there is watching me, and he's like, he's dying. For sure he's dying. And then we're gonna roll all the way down. He's got a big smile on his face going, this sucks, but it's effective. And we're gonna work our way all the way down to just above the knee. When you're done, dump the bar. Still got it. Same thing on the other side. You're gonna work your way all the way down. So just along the outside and then that entire center portion of the leg. That's number one. Number two is we're gonna take the leg, we're gonna bring it all the way this way, and we're gonna take the lacrosse ball, and we're gonna trap it in behind the shin. So we can see this is the shin, so we got the tibia here. We're gonna tuck the ball in just behind. I'm gonna push down and I'm gonna take this all the way. This is miserable. And unglue that tibialis posterior. If this isn't enough, take your thumb, drive it in behind there if you've got the willpower and the cojones to do it. drive that thumb in behind the shin on the back side on the inside of the leg and just crank away on circles all the way down. Just stay away from the ankle. All right, that's number two. Number three is we want to clear out all this stuff on the front. There's two ways of doing it. I like using a tool that you can take with you anywhere, which is a lacrosse ball. It's super easy. So we're gonna take this. It's gonna run essentially all down the lateral portion of the shin. You can use a foam roller, you can use a barbell, you can use anything you want. I like this because it's easy. Packs in a suitcase or a bag, throw it in your car. So we're gonna run all the way down. So this is the shin. Don't roll that, okay? You're never gonna get it supple, trust me. So we're gonna roll all along the outside. So basically, take this. See if we can move this just a bit. My big fat thumb in the way. So we're gonna take this, right, you can see me, and then we're just gonna smash and smear all the way down. I'll come over here so you can see what I'm doing. So I'm gonna take that, I'm trapping the outside of that tibialis anterior. I'm gonna point the toe, and I'm gonna smash and smear all the way up and down. Oh, that's awful. All the way up and down. That's number two. Number three. This is number four, is we're gonna get the back too. We're gonna hit that biceps morse and the calf complex. We're gonna tuck this in behind. I would ideally probably use a softball instead because it's bigger, has more contact, especially for a bigger person. And then we're just gonna sit here. I'll go to this side so you can see what I'm doing. So we're gonna take this, tuck it in behind here, hold this tight, and just work that calf and that hamstring all the way down as far as you can. All right, that's number four. Number five, this is the fun one. So we're gonna do this standing, but you're just gonna see my foot. So we're gonna take the foot. What I want you to do is you can see my foot here. We're gonna basically flatten out the arch and then we're gonna bring it up. How about we do this? Just take the sock off so you can actually see my foot. So we're gonna take the foot, we're gonna flatten out the arch, and then we're gonna curl the toes. Flatten it out, curl the toes. Flatten it out, curl the toes. But what I'm trying to do is I'm really trying to load up all under here, which is where that tibialis posterior comes around and hooks underneath. So it creates a lot of that arch. So flatten, hook it up. That's it, 3 sets of 10, call it a day. Hey, listen, I'm Trev, SmashweRx, hanging out at CSA on a Monday. I'll check you guys out tomorrow. Have an awesome day.